Hello, welcome to the second part on building terminal applications with Go by using Bubble Tea. Today we're going to continue and see how to do a weather app. So here I have already prepared a client over the MetaWeather API. So this is basically an HTTP client over the JSON API. It's doing two calls, one to get a location and another one to get a weather for a location. So I'm mixing those two calls into one. And you will be able to see this code in the repository I will link in the video description. So let's get back to it. Here in the application, I'm gonna start a new empty model. And the same way we did last time, we are gonna exit the application by hitting Ctrl C and nothing more. Okay, so the idea of the application is that we ask the user for an input, a location, then we show a spinner, and we fetch the location and weather info. We can get an error, so we will show that error, or we can get a weather, so we will show the weather. So we need three states in the application. You see, first is typing. Then we need loading. And then we need either error or location. The weather will come inside this location, inside consolidated weather. So now, for the typing, we are gonna show here from Bubbles. They have this text input component, so we are gonna use that. So here in the model, we're gonna define a text input model. It's already imported here. So in the initial model, we are gonna set the text input to be input new model, and we are gonna initialize typing as true. We also need to focus on this input there. Now here on init, we need to call text input dot blink. This is gonna make the cursor of the input to start blinking. Now here in update, we need to pass a message to the input component. So if we are typing, we are gonna call update. So like so. This is documented in their here in the examples. Now we just need to come here to the view and show the text input. So if we are typing, we are gonna return the typing component alongside some label like enter location. Like so. Let's give it a try. Go build. And there we go. We can type stuff here. And now the next step is to handle the enter key. So let's exit. Here inside the key message event, we are gonna listen for enter. And we're gonna set typing to false, loading to true, and we are gonna return for now. Now we also need to show a spinner while loading. So we're gonna use this component right here, the spinner. Like so. I'm gonna change the default spinner to be a dot. There we go. And here, the same way, if we are loading, we're gonna update the spinner component. And here, when we hit enter, we're gonna make the spinner to tick. So in the view, now, if we are loading, we're gonna show the spinner. Like so. So let's give it a try. You can see the spinner is actually spinning. Okay, now let's fetch the weather. So we're gonna need a reference to the client. We just did here. So in the model, let's call it meta weather. We need to initialize this. There we go. So here, when we hit enter, we also need to dispatch a command to fetch the weather. We'll define it here inside the model. Weather. So this is going to return a command, which is basically a function that returns a message. So we're going to call location by query, by passing the background context and a query. This is gonna return a location and an error. So here a message can actually be anything. So we're gonna define a message called got weather. It's gonna be a struct of two values, an error and a location. So here we're gonna return with got weather, but with an error, and down here with the location. So now in the update, after we hit enter, we're gonna make the spinner to tick and also to fetch the weather. So we are gonna use this function called tbatch that is gonna compose both commands. And we get the query from the text input that value. I'm gonna save it this into a variable, like so. And only do this if this is not empty, so. Also, I will make sure this is not just empty space, so I will trim the spaces. There we go. So now we need to listen for this message. Got weather. So below the key message event, we're gonna do another case. If we get an error, I'm gonna set the error typing and loading to false. just that. Otherwise, gonna set the location, load into false, and return. Actually, this loading is the same, so we can put it up here. In both cases. Like so. So, here in the view, now, if we get an error, we're gonna print it. Cool, not fetch weather. And otherwise, we're gonna just print the weather. Say current weather in some place. Is the weather value is actually a float, so I think I'm gonna print it without any decimals. And in Celsius degrees. This needs to be like so. By the way, I'm using GitHub Copilot for these auto-completions. Okay, let's give it a try. So, enter some random place. I get the error. Let's try again. Santiago. We don't get the current weather. Nice. Now let's try to, I don't know, maybe hit the escape so we can type a new location. All right. So here in the key message, we're gonna do another case for escape. So in the case of escape, we're gonna set type into true. And we're gonna clean up the error. And that's it. Actually, I'm gonna do these handlers only, for instance, enter will only work if we are seeing the text input. So if typing, we're gonna do this. And if we are not typing, we're gonna do this. Actually, if we are not also loading, nice. So, we can search for a random place. We didn't get anything. We hit escape and we are back. We can search for another place. Nice. We can try again. Cool. So yeah, I think that's everything for this video. I will link the code to this in the video description inside the GitHub repository so you can take a look. And please leave any question down below in the comment section. Thank you for watching and stay tuned.